Welcome to the Audio Renaissance unabridged presentation of How to Become CEO, the Rules for Rising to the Top of Any Organization. Written by Jeffrey J. Fox. Produced by Tony Hutz. And now here is Jeffrey J. Fox.
Introduction. Why you should listen to this program. Having ambition to better yourself, to be a contributor, to make a difference, to grow professionally, to be more successful, or to become CEO of an organization is good. CEO is the acronym for Chief Executive Officer. The CEO is the person who has strategic responsibility for the fortune and the future of the organization. The CEO may be called headmistress, managing partner, general of the armies, pontiff, commander-in-chief, queen, or warden. But whatever the title, the CEO is the boss. If becoming the boss is what you want, this program will help. There are oodles of factors that influence the path to CEO. Work habits, luck, timing, competitors, personality, supporters, talent, circumstances, and so on. This program will help you better your work habits, influence the odds, impact timing, surpass competitors, and deftly use your talent. The ideas are based on the realities of business and organizations. The ideas are not part of any MBA curriculum. They are crisp, blunt, frank, generally non-judgmental, and easy to listen to, digest, and do. Many of the recommendations are stated in rule or commandment form. This is because what is written is the way it is, not the way it ought to be. Although the content is intended to help you progress, the observations and advice are often applicable to your non-work life and activities as well. The surest way to become president or CEO of a corporation is to buy a business or to start a business. And now, here's how to become CEO, the rules for rising to the top of any organization. 1. Always take the job that offers the most money. After you've decided what you want to do, whether it is banking, advertising, manufacturing, or something else, go to work for the company that offers you the most money. If you have not decided what kind of career or industry is for you, then take the job that offers the most money. If you are in a corporation, always take the transfer, promotion, or assignment that pays the most money. There are several important reasons why you go for the money. First, all of your benefits, perquisites, bonuses, and subsequent raises will be based on your salary. Corporations give all extra compensation in percentages. Therefore, a 10% raise on a $22,000 salary is $200 better than the same raise on a $20,000 salary. Second, the higher paid you are, the more visible to top management you will be. Third, the more money you are paid, the more contribution will be expected of you. This means you will be given more responsibility, tasks, and problems to solve, and a chance to perform is an invitation to success. Fourth, if two people are candidates for a promotion to a job that pays $50,000, and one person makes $30,000 and the other $40,000, the higher paid person always gets the job. The higher paid person gets the job regardless of talent, contribution, or anything else. Corporations usually take the easy way out, and it is easier to promote the higher paid than the lower. Promoting the higher paid is the path of no resistance in most organizations. Someone approved the higher paid person's compensation. Others concurred. To leapfrog the higher paid diminishes the sponsor of the higher paid. And the sponsors of the higher paid are themselves even higher paid. Promoting the higher paid endorses the wisdom of upper management. Finally, in business, money is the scorecard. The more you make, the better you're doing. Simple. 2. Avoid staff jobs, seek line jobs. Line jobs make money for your corporation. Line jobs bring in money or have direct relationship with profits and loss. The distinction between line and staff is sometimes blurred in corporations, but line jobs are where the action is. Line jobs include salespeople, sales managers, product managers, plant managers, marketing directors, foremen, supervisors, and general managers. Staff jobs include lawyers, planners, data processing people, research and development scientists, and administrators of all types. Line jobs directly help the company get and keep customers. Legitimate staff jobs indirectly get and keep customers. Jobs that don't get and keep customers are redundant. In most companies, most of the people are either in administration or in field sales. Administrative people are not bad, nor untalented, but they are not at the cutting edge. The company doesn't depend on them. Take a staff job only if it is clearly temporary, a stepping stone, and if it pays more money. Be sure you know what the line and staff jobs in your company are. Be sure to get the right one. 3. Don't expect the personnel department to plan your career. Amazingly, many managers think the personnel department, also known as human resources, is supposed to construct a career path for them. They think companies actually have a grand plan for them. Some managers think there is some kind of preordained job ladder, as in the Army or a police department. A young manager does basic training, and the omniscient corporation promotes him or her to the next level up the pyramid. It doesn't work that way. Corporations don't have career plans for future presidents. It is doubtful if they have them for anybody. Your destiny and your career growth are your responsibility and no one else's. You have to know what you want. You have to design the plan to get there. You have to determine what skills and functional expertise are needed to get to the top in your company. Your responsibility is to acquire that experience. 4. Get and keep customers. Customers are the lifeblood of any company. Everybody should know this. Everybody says the customer is king, and we work for the customer, and the customer is the real boss. But very few employees in a corporation do anything to demonstrate they believe in this dictum. Commonly, the higher an executive gets and the bigger the company, the less they deal with real, honest-to-goodness, existing and potential customers. Executives reorganize companies, eliminate jobs, and excuse the chaos by saying they are two or three levels closer to the customer. Bunk. There are no barriers between anyone in the corporation and the customer. Why do so few people really work to get and keep customers? Because dealing with customers is tough. Customers reject sellers. They negotiate. They make harsh demands. They expect their needs to be filled, and they can be fickle. Also, dealing with administrative functions is an easier, impersonal, and safe task. You must deal with today's customers and tomorrow's customers. They provide the ideas for new products and new applications. They provide the early warning signals about your product's quality and timeliness. They know about your competitors. To know your customers is to know your future. When the phone rings, 12 people ought to dive to answer it. The customer is indeed king, and the future president understands how the customer is also the kingmaker. 5. Keep physically fit. Your brain will make you money, but your body carries your brain. The better your physical condition, the greater your capacity for productive, unrelenting work. And being in good condition gives you another edge. 90% of all people climbing the corporate ladder are out of shape. You will be able to start earlier, pause less often, and end your day with a wind sprint. You will also sleep better. You will be energetic and tire rarely. Your spirits will be up and you will not get depressed. You will have the energy and motivation to, at night and on weekends, coach soccer, attend the theater, volunteer. How you keep fit is up to you. 6. Do something hard and lonely. Regularly practice something Spartan and individualistic. Do something that you know very few other people are willing to do. This will give you a feeling of toughness, a certain self-elitism. It will mentally prepare you for the battle of business. Something that is hard and lonely is studying late at night for a graduate degree in fashion design, especially in the winter when everyone else is asleep. Or running long, slow distances early in the morning versus jogging at lunchtime with a mob. Split wood, write, work in the garden, read King Lear, but do it by yourself. Do something that is solitary. All great and successful athletes remember the endless hours of seemingly unrewarded toil. So do corporate presidents.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.